Introduction to power flow analysis. Holomorphic embedding load flow method. As we have shown in the first part of this series, one of the features and also the main problem in power flow analysis is that the power flow equation is not linear. Nonlinear equations can be solved using Newton method. However, Newton method is sensitive to the initial guess of the solution. It may not always yield the desired high voltage solution. To find a method that can univocally yield the high voltage solution whenever such solution exists, let us look deeper into the properties of the power flow equation. For a well-connected power network, the node admittance matrix YEQ has rank n-1, where n is the number of nodes in the power system. So to solve a power flow equation, we need to choose a node whose voltage is a predetermined reference value. This node is usually called the slack bus. Also, power flow equation is scalable. That is to say, if V is the solution to the equation, S equals to V entry-wise dot YEQ V conjugate, then U equals to alpha V is the solution to the equation alpha squared S equals to U entry-wise dot YEQ U conjugate. Therefore, by rescaling the node admittance matrix YEQ, the voltage value of the slack bus is arbitrary. It is usually set to 1 per unit. If we parameterized the power flow equation as S equals to lambda times V entry-wise product YEQ V conjugate, then lambda equals 0 corresponds to a trivial high voltage solution. For example, when all the nodes have the same voltage as the slack bus, whereas lambda equals to 1 corresponds to the high voltage solution we actually want. So the main idea of HELM is that if we can embed the power flow equation into algebraic equations of holomorphic functions, then as lambda goes from 0 to 1, the series approximation of the voltage will converge univocally to the desired high voltage solution whenever such solution exists. This univocality comes from the fact that within the radius of convergence, holomorphic functions can be approximate arbitrarily close to the true value with series representation. If all the holomorphic functions embedding the voltage has a radius of convergence greater than 1 at lambda equals 0, the series converges at lambda equals 1. Otherwise, it diverges. Let us now go into the actual workflow of HELM. The first step is to embed the voltage and its complex conjugate with a holomorphic function. The reason why we need this holomorphic embedding is because the complex conjugate of V is not a holomorphic function. However, another function, which we shall call it V hat henceforth, is holomorphic if we define it as the conjugate of voltage, taking the conjugate of lambda as argument. Therefore, the following set of equations are holomorphic. V hat entry-wise dot YEQ V equals to lambda S conjugate, and V entry-wise dot Y conjugate V hat equals to lambda S. The second step is the power series representation of the voltage. The form of the power series depends on the type of nodes in the power network. In the simplest case, all nodes other than the slack bus are PQ buses. That is to say, real and reactive power at the nodes are given. Then we can set the power series V equals to VK lambda to the kth power, and V hat equals to V hat K lambda to the kth power. The third step is term-by-term matching. For every K, both sides of the power flow equation must be equal. Using this rationale, the coefficient Vk and V hat K are solved recursively starting from K equals to 0. For K equals to 0, V0 is the trivial high voltage solution, while V hat 0 is the complex conjugate of V0. For K equals to 1, the corresponding coefficient on the right-hand side of the power flow equation is S conjugate and S. So V1 and V hat 1 are obtained by solving V hat 0 entry-wise dot YEQ V1 equals to S conjugate and V0 entry-wise dot YEQ conjugate V hat 1 equals to S. Notice that we already know V0 and V hat 0 at this stage. So V1 and V hat 1 can be solved directly from these two equations. For k equals to 2, the corresponding coefficient on the right-hand side of the power flow equation is 0. So V2 and V hat 2 are obtained by solving V hat 0 entry-wise dot YEQ V2 plus V hat 1 entry-wise dot YEQ V1 equals to 0 and V0 entry-wise dot YEQ conjugate V hat 2 plus V1 entry-wise dot YEQ conjugate V hat 1 equals to 0. Again, V0, V1, V hat 0, and V hat 1 are all known at this stage. So V2 and V hat 2 can be solved directly from these two equations. This process can continue for arbitrarily large k. The last step of HELM is Padé approximant. When a power system is near the bifurcation point, the power series can converge or diverge slowly. Construction of a Padé approximant from the original power series can give us a more robust indication whether the series converges or not. If there exists a root of the Padé approximant whose magnitude is smaller or equal to 1, then the original power series diverges. Okay, let us demonstrate the concepts presented before by a trivial example. This is a ring structure microgrid of 10 nodes, with the zeros node being the slack bus. Each node draws the same power, S equals to minus 0.05 per unit from the grid, and each line has the same impedance. We run the HELM with 20 turns of the power series. If you run the C++ code I provided in a link given in the description or in the comment, using the same parameters, you will get these results. In the first part of the output, we can see the resulting voltage by directly summing up all the coefficients of the power series. It is difficult to tell whether or not the series diverges with this result. In the second part of the output, we can see that the Padé approximant of the voltage yields slightly lower values compared with the direct summation. The Padé approximant converges to the high voltage solution faster than the direct summation whenever such solution exists, but it may still converge even when a high voltage solution does not exist. In the third part of the output, we can see that there is a root of the Padé approximant whose magnitude is smaller than 1. This implies that the power series diverges and there is no solution to the original power flow equation. Indeed, if we increase the number of turns of the power series to 100, we can start seeing the result of the direct summation diverges. Meanwhile, with 100 turns, the Padé approximant of the voltage still does not diverge, but there will be more holes whose magnitude is smaller than 1. What are the potential problems when using HELM? The first is the computational burden of finding the roots. Calculating the Padé approximant only makes sense when the roots of the approximant are also calculated. Root searching for high-order polynomials incurs additional computational burden. And also, spurious holes of Padé approximant can occur if the number of power terms is very large due to numerical errors. Sophisticated method exists to clean up the spurious holes.